Hello. Going to be starting a brand new painting today, and looking pretty forward to this one. So let me tell you what I got going on here. Once again, going to be using an 18 by 24 stretched canvas. I've gone through and completely gessoed in black the entire canvas, and then I've come through and I've used my charcoal pencil and created kind of a basic roadmap here on a sketch for our next piece, and it's going to be a lion. The whole canvas is going to pretty much be covered up by just the lion's face. We'll have a little bit of a paw sticking out here. He'll be resting on a rock or stone, and we'll have a lot of light coming in here. We'll have some shadow cast over here. All this will be his mane, so just something a little bit different, kind of get away from some of the standard things I've been doing lately, which have been a lot of seascapes, a lot of ships, done a lot of different things like that, nature scenes, and so just want to kind of keep it interesting and keep it different. I like to do that, try to keep challenging myself, trying new things, get away from my comfort zone, that type of thing. So that's what we'll be working on here, and I invite you to please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you look up my name, Mark Harville, YouTube, you should find me just fine. I've got a lot of videos on there, training tutorials, and tips and tricks that hopefully can be of value or help to you. So appreciate you subscribing, and we'll get going on this new painting. So as we get going on this painting, I'm going to start working on the mouth first, and then we'll kind of expand out from there. So what we'll do is start first on the tongue and bring all that in, work around the gums, the lips, and then into the teeth is how I think I'd like to start this. So the tongue is going to be, we're going to start this off, I'm going to use a little bit of alizarin crimson. I'm going to grab some white to get that kind of opaque. And then with that, I'll add a little bit of purple, and we'll get it kind of dark. So crimson, dioxazine purple, a little white. And we'll come in here and we'll start getting all this, the shadow underpainting, kind of blocked in here. And I don't need to be real precise when it comes to where I've put my marks here for my sketch, but I'll try to work around a little bit. Accidentally picked up a little bit of black there and didn't mean to do that. That's all right. what I love about painting is that you can come up with virtually nothing. When you get started, it looks like it's nothing. It looks like the markings of a second grader. But then as you start building into it, magically it comes alive. It starts to slowly come out of the canvas. And I always just love that process where that kind of happens. All right, now while that's still wet, I'm gonna come in with some black, because I wanna kind of bring in the darkest part of his mouth, which, you know, kind of leading into the back of his throat.
Thank you.
All right. So now, at this point, we're going to lighten up our gray mixture that we created. And a little bit of yellow. Maybe a little bit of orange. And then coming back here, and we start the first highlight onto the tooth. And do the same thing with the next one. Mix a little bit more white, yellow, orange, and our gray mixture. So, kind of the same thing here. Apologize for the loudness of my family as usual. When they get home, they get loud. That's the reality of things. And wipe the excess out and come back and kind of blend that in. Excuse me. Excuse me again. So what we want to do is kind of underpaint the chin around the mouth and kind of around the nose. And the way we want to do that so around the mouth and closest to the mouth will be white fur, and then furthest away kind of starts to turn the brown orange that we were used to seeing on lions. So I think the first rule of business for us is taking a little white, grabbing just a little blue, I'm gonna grab just a smidgen of black. And that's what's gonna kind of make up my color. Around the mouth. It doesn't have to be perfect or anything. And we don't need to get real detailed. We just need to kind of get it blocked in. Canvas is bouncing around here on me. We'll still follow the angles. Mix some more color. Ultramarine blue. And charcoal black. With a little bit of our titanium white. Okay. Now, coming here around the nose, follow these angles. And we'll do that over here too. Go into some ultramarine blue, since that's the complement color to orange. Grab a little bit of white.
Now, I think what we'll want to do with our orange, we'll just kind of lay it in. Some more orange and blue, a little white. Not an enormous amount of detail or anything. So just bringing it in. Wherever we think we're going to find it. That's really all I want to kind of do is just find, kind of throw that in, because the real detail will come right after that. So now that we've got that put in, I think what I'd like to do is start working on the eyes. So we'll get those blocked in. Okay, so on this other eye, we want to start doing, we're first going to bring in some gray, and actually I'm going to use white. Use some white, use some umber, A little more umber than white, though. Okay. This will be the white of the eye, but we're going to start with this light brownish umber color to begin. So that'll be showing kind of the white of the eye. Then we're going to come back again with our blue and orange. And I just want to block this whole thing in real dark like we did with the other one. So to do that, come grab our orange and blue. Let's do a little more blue. Okay. So we've brought in the eye. Now around the eye, we want to paint in some of the black. So coming here with my round brush. All this. Just be black. Okay, now what we want to do is kind of bring in some of our glossiness to that. So go into our kind of our lighter orange blue. Let's see if this is too bright or not. Bring in the pupil real quick and then we can work around it. We're gonna focus our attention on the chin, and what I want to do is pop in to the chin area just a couple dark spots where I know we're gonna have some really deep shadow. And it's just gonna be just a few touches of some dark color. That'll kind of just be showing through. Dark color interspersed. It'll just eventually be the most deepest shadowy parts of the chin. And a lot will get covered up by hair. Okay. That's really kind of all we wanted to do there. Now, under this lip, we're going to have just a series of dark hair be kind of running. Kind of running away from the lip initially to start. Thing is, we're going to have maybe a little bit of orange coming through the beard as well, on this chin. So I'm going to make up a little batch with some yellow, some orange, a little sienna. Put a little bit of white in there to lighten it up and sort of opaque it. Wipe the excess off my brush, but I do want to, kind of in the middle region here, I want to just bring in a small little bit of indication that there will be some hairs. A little bit lighter. Don't need a lot, but kind of through this region here.
So as we work on this upper lip and nose area, I'm actually going to thicken this line right here. So I'm going to go ahead and take our fan brush and we'll go into our blue. Get it nice and soupy again. Too soupy. Let's add a little white to that. The nose region here is going to be casting a shadow, so we want to keep this fairly dark, but as we come into the lighter region, it's not picking that up, so I'm going to get a little soupier. So that kind of gets it started. Get several of those little strokes in pretty quickly. We'll come back with our script liner brush. Thank you.
Okay, now taking my soft vine charcoal, I want to identify where I'm going to have all my little hairs. More or less, that's kind of where I envision it. So now, coming back to our number two round brush, we come in and grab our black. Make a series of dots. We're going to start working around the eyes, and the way we want to do this, I'm going to start with some blue over here. Opaque that a little more. Got a little bit of that over here too. Then we'll kind of work around. Okay, so then around the eye, we're going to bring in our dark orange, yellow color, which is just a kind of orange, muddy orange with blue mixed in there. Just kind of underpaint in a little bit of dark orange color.
create a large pile of some of our big yellowish lion color. So orange, yellow, white, a little sienna. And we're going to mix a little blue into our pile, kind of darken that up a little bit. Put a little umber in there. The box is in purple as well. That's not the right color you want. Come on, get that a little darker. So this hair comes in clumps. Plenty of negative space. You have that black showing through. Right off the canvas. our script liner brush. Let's start doing our individual hairs. Thank you.
through here now, and I'm just adding some highlighted sections here in white. Just using pure white. So I really want some of this to pop where I know the sun's really hitting it. Going in real thick too. Bring in that contrast. Through here, I want to have kind of some good highlights on his forehead. So short, choppy strokes. To come in thick. Thank you.
bring in some interesting things. Sienna. Tad bit of red. And thank you. been working on this painting, I've kind of been thinking about this area right here, and I'm not overly thrilled really with how it's looking right now. I want to come through and change it, and I think make it a little more subtle. So what I think I want to do is I'm just going to repaint kind of over this section here. I'm going to grab my gesso. I've got some black gesso here. And we're gonna bring it back to black. I guess that's the beautiful thing about painting. There are some things in this world we can't change. Some things in this world we don't have control over. But we do have control over painting. And if we don't like something we've done, we can make it better. Smooth that out. Let that dry. And then we will start all over on that. So while we're waiting on that, though, I think what we can start on would be the paw. Get this paw going here. And we'll let this dry, and then we'll come back and finish that up. But I think, for the most part, the painting's coming along pretty well. We'll get the paw in, we'll complete the hair on the mane the way I'd like to see it, and then he's resting on a large boulder, so this is going to become our boulder here. So we'll get this going and take it to that point. Thank you. where I work in this area right here now. It's dried up. And what we want to do is we want to keep it fairly dark, but we'll add some highlights. So what we're going to kind of do here is kind of bring some of this out. I just want this to look kind of like we've got some a little bit of background color coming through a little bit. More of his arm right here. I want it to be pretty ghosted. So we'll just keep it pretty dark still. And just kind of lead back into nothing. Allow this to be really dark, so we don't need a whole lot, but just enough to kind of give an indication that some of the hair is sort of showing through. Come back. A little bit lighter now. Okay, so at this point, we're kind of at a stage where we just kind of want to kind of fine tune some things. I want to bring in a little more of some of our dark and shadow through some of the hair. So I want to have some nice dark pockets. And kind of help to give a little bit better separation. Here. I think it'll provide a pretty nice contrast. Some of the sections here. Just let some of that go into a little bit deeper shadow. While I'm thinking about it, I want a little more dark separation to the nose, just a little bit more here. Pretty simple. Something like that. And I think this is something we can call complete. It was a really fun experience. Just to recap what we've got going on here, we used an 18 by 24 inch stretched canvas. Everything is painted in acrylic, and thought it would be fun to just try something a little bit different here and focus on making kind of a cool angry lion. So had a good time painting that, presenting it to you. Hope that was helpful. Please continue to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's just called Mark Carville. And I appreciate you subscribing and tuning in. We'll look forward to presenting again a new painting, a whole brand new painting, something new and different and interesting. So I'll think real hard on that. And if you have any suggestions on things that you'd like to see painted, please let me know and I'll take that into consideration. So thanks so much for tuning in.